Good morning. Oh, school bus is there. It is morning. It is exactly 8 o'clock and I am logging in, but I have to do the password correctly. I've been up for a little bit. Somebody was sawing logs and in the morning I just couldn't go back to sleep. All right, and then, you know, noises and things like that. It's a rainy day here in Cincinnati, Ohio, and windy. I'm going to check for leaks and places that leak. And actually, I'm going to get my wife's car out of the grass and the mud so that she doesn't have to do it whenever she gets up and moving. But I needed to log into work. So make your Friday what you want your Friday to be. It's been one of those kind of weeks, a short work week for me. And we've got some craziness to encounter this weekend, which remains to be seen. All right. You know, like I said, make your day. Wish me luck. All of those things that we do here. This done. Well, it's not raining hard. The car move. Question is, can I be super quiet with the door? It takes some effort, but it's possible. Oh yeah, it's raining. Yick. Yeah, because we have so many people parking here lately. It's just a mud, tire track mud path in here. Oh, it's a little Mazda Miata. All right, that was the relatively easy part. I won't move the seat so as to mess her up. Now, I have to do a quick check on our beep. Our mole incursion here is continued, look. Let us move the trap. Since its current location didn't seem to bother our friendly local mole. It's a mess everywhere. Welcome to your rainy Friday. Hope it calms down before we do what we're gonna do later. Here's another fun little thing. I don't remember purchasing this pair of Lucky Brand jeans. Maybe my wife did, but they're definitely mine because they're definitely my size. And they put a little quote unquote, you know, fortune in here. It's not really a fortune, but it was in the pocket. It cracks me up. All right, but I'm going to throw it away now because every time I reach in the pocket, I'm like, what's that? And while I'm filming a lot today, in other news, Perfect North Slopes has announced that they are officially closed for the season. So it looks like skis, woof, and boots need to get taken back downstairs where they go for storage. Kind of bummed by that, actually. Sometimes we have, you know, cold marches. And I just didn't feel like I skied enough, but whatever, it is what it is. I'm gonna do what needs to happen every now and again with your phone. I need to offload apps and like delete them and then reinstall them because it's app load is what it is. As you use your apps on your phone, Facebook, you know, that kind of stuff. They increasingly have data attached to them. And really the only way to get rid of that is to delete the app and then re-download it and re-log in. So I'm just going to check my logins to make sure that I know them and take care of that. So on a non-work project this morning, I do have a pretty big work thing that I just discovered that I have to do. Well, I don't have to do it. It's maintaining my certifications. It's just I have continuing education things that they want us to do and it's not required. See, none of these are required, they're just recommended, but I need to get those done too. I told you, it's time for these to get back downstairs. Although I have at some point thought that the border up here would be a good place to just hang them up, you know, just for decoration, but I don't know, this place needs a rebuild anyway. I decided to clean up in here a little bit, as I mentioned earlier, and I finally got the vacuum out and back together. It was like wasn't completely together. And so I unplugged the heater to plug that in and noticed something interesting here. Look at that. This, my folks, is why they say don't plug heaters into extension cords. Now, I've been doing that for quite some time,
And I know the extension cord occasionally gets a little warm, so I'll turn it off. But it's been running a lot today. I don't know why. My bad. So don't do that. And I maybe might have to like throw this heater away because that looks like it's compromised. Maybe. Don't do that. Lesson learned. I'm glad it didn't catch fire. I turned on our little sump pump, which we've got in our basement, and it has sprung a leak. So I need to, I've got some, whatever the special, there it is, flex tape. And I'm going to patch the leak in the hose. Oh, such a bummer.
Check that out. Just checking the roof. Okay, no, nothing on it. Just things have fallen elsewhere around in the yard and out front. Okay, just checking.
Ignore the music. Yes, I'm at the airport again.
Cutters?
Yeah.
Cut right in front of you, why don't you?
Did you want to be on the
show? No, I took you again.
While we were at the airport, I got a phone call from my neighbor that one of her big pine trees in the front yard had fallen over into my yard, which then led to me realizing when I checked on the Ring camera that our power was out. So her tree took out the power. This Friday night, whole family's at the airport. I got nothing I can do about it. It worked out though, but it did take until Saturday night. This is Friday, Saturday night. For the energy folks to come and rehook the power line up. But of course they needed to get in the house, so I had to call another family member. It was kind of a mess, but it all worked out. So there, I had to throw that in there because I refer to it later.
We have been here before. At the Residence Inn, Flamingo Crossings. All right, let's go to bed and get up in the morning and go where we're going.
We haven't been on Tom Sawyer's Island in a number of years, so that's where we went. I'm sorry.
How'd you knock in?
Nothing.
Thank you.
in.
While everybody else was riding Tron, well, waiting in line to ride Tron, I went shopping and then walked up the exit to check out the ride. Ooh, there go some people. Don't know who they are. It's pretty cool looking, not gonna lie.
Ben, hold your turkey leg up.
So, you know, we cheaped out and we got the inexpensive flight that flew at 5:45 and then got to Atlanta. And then we're going to have a 5-hour layover in Atlanta and leave about 12 something. And then the incoming flight was delayed and then it was delayed some more. And we ended up sitting there for a total of 9 hours. As you'll see here, we boarded at 4:00. And it wasn't until we landed in Cincinnati that somebody asked the one flight attendant. He said, oh, yeah, we just had a signal saying that the door was open after we took off. So we had to turn back and land back in Cincinnati and then get the light warning fixed. And then we were able to come.
Okay, the Duke trucks, thank you for fixing our power. Kind of tore that up a little bit, that's okay. And it's a lovely night back home in Cincinnati, Ohio on this Sunday evening where we should have been home hours ago. I have a sprung mole trap. I have some air that needs to be in the tire, and the tree that fell, as you can see, has been mostly cleaned up. You know, cleaned up out of our yard. She was very apologetic that it fell in our yard. And, oh, I didn't mean to do that. All right, let's see if there's a mole on here. Yeah, of course, this is happening too, if you can hear me at all. That's not loud. Wow, oh, I gotta change these brake pads.